All right, this is 2.2 using metric units for length. Last unit was 2.1 talking about imperial. Now we're going to use metric. What's nice about the metric system is that everything is base 10. So all we need to do is simple calculations involving multiples of 10. 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, and makes it really, really easy to use the metric system. So try these. 1.56 by 10. Well, we're multiplying anything by 10. All we need to do is we're multiplying. We're moving the decimal place to the right. So 1.56 times 10, we take the decimal point, we move it there, and we end up with 15.6. That's what's so nice about the metric system, that it being base 10, it's easy to multiply and divide. We just move the decimal point. The numbers stay the same. The decimal point just shifts to the left or to the right, depending on whether we're multiplying or whether we're dividing. So 545.9 times 100, we're going to move the decimal point to the right because we're multiplying it two spaces. So there's one and there's two. And when I've got a little loop with nothing in there, I put a zero in there. So I end up with 54590, or 54,590. 0.125 times 1,000, well, I'm multiplying it, so I'm moving it to the right three spaces because there's three zeros. So I start here and I go 1, 2, 3, and end up with the number 125. Let's move over to number 4. 75.34 divided by 10. When I'm dividing it, I'm moving the decimal point to the left instead of to the right. And I'm dividing it by 10, which means I move it one space. So I move the decimal point one space to the left, and that was 7.534. 897.5 divided by 100, I'm dividing it, so again I'm moving it to the left. Two zeros are there, so I'm moving it two spaces. 1, 2, and I end up with 8.975. 8.25 divided by 1,000, I'm moving it three spaces. I have three zeros, three spaces to the left. There's 1, that's where the 8 is. And then 2, 3, put the decimal point there where I've got two little loops, I put zeros. So I end up with 0.00825. Okay, so that's not too hard. The SI system, or System International, is known as the metric system. This system was developed in France in the year 1791 to standardize all types of measurement around the world. The base unit for length is the meter. Okay, you'll notice that the meter is right there in the middle. All other units are written in terms of the base unit using powers of 10. Okay, so we start at a meter, the number 1. 1 decameter is the same as 10 meters because it's 10 times bigger. So a decameter is multiplying it by 10, so it takes 10 meters to make a decameter. Hectometer, we're multiplying it by 100, so it takes 100 meters to make a hectometer. And then a kilometer, it's not kilometer, it's pronounced kilometer. There's 1,000 meters in a kilometer, okay? And then if we're going to go smaller, we have a decimeter. It takes 10 decimeters to make 1 meter. It takes 100 centimeters to make 1 meter, and it takes 1,000 millimeters to make a 1 meter. So these units down here, they are smaller than a meter, and these units up here, they are larger than a meter. Since this measurement system uses base 10, the same as our number system, measurements are expressed as decimals. Okay, it's really easy to convert between units in the metric system because everything is base 10 and all we need to do is move the decimal point. We don't need to change the numbers. Circle the larger unit in each pair, centimeter or meter. The larger unit, well, we know that a meter is larger than a centimeter. A millimeter or decimeter, decimeter is larger. Hectometer or kilometer, kilometer is larger. Decameter or centimeter, well, decameter is larger than a centimeter. Okay, so let's go to number 2. How many centimeters are in 5 meters? Well, we know that 1 meter contains 100 centimeters, so 5 meters is just 5 times 100 centimeters per meter, and we end up with 500 centimeters in 5 meters. how many kilometers are in 8.5, sorry, how many meters are in 8.5 kilometers? Well, we know that 1 kilometer has 1,000 meters in it, so 8.5 kilometers times 1,000 meters per kilometer, that's our conversion ratio, and we end up with 8,500 meters, because we're going to move the decimal point three places, because we're multiplying to the right. There's one, there's two, there's three. Put the zeros there and the decimal point there. That's how we end up with 8,500. Okay? Let's go to example number one. Paula rides her bike to her friend's house 4.5 kilometers away. She could also run, taking 1 meter strides. How many strides would she take? Well, let's look at the solution. A, will the number of meters be greater or less than the number of kilometers in this distance? Well, we know that there's more meters in a kilometer, so it's going to be greater. It's going to be a larger number of meters in a kilometer. 1 kilometer is 1,000 meters. How can you use this relationship to figure out the number of meters in 4.5 kilometers? Well, we just take the 4.5 and we multiply it by 1,000. Okay? So we take 4.5 kilometers. We multiply it by 1,000 meters per kilometer. And how many strides would Paula take? She would just take 4,500 strides. Because if we're going to do the multiplication, we're moving the decimal place to the right. There's three zeros, three spaces. One, two, three. Put the decimal point there. Fill in those little loops with zeros. We end up with 4,500 strides. Okay, so what's nice about the metric system or the SI system is because it's base 10, the numbers do not change, just the place value of the decimal. Why does this happen? Because it's all base 10. Everything is base 10. Rulers and tape measures that use the metric system divide a meter into 100 parts and a centimeter into 10 parts. So this is the basic display of a meter stick. It's in centimeters. Okay, so we know it's going to go up to 100 centimeters, and then we take a centimeter, divide it into 10 equal parts, and each one of these little tiny spaces in here are millimeters. Okay, so example number two. The diameter of a loonie is about 26.5 or 26.5 millimeters. Diameter is from here here. Okay. What is the measure in centimeters? So 26.5 millimeters. Well, will the number of centimeters be greater or less than the number of millimeters? We know that millimeters are smaller, or takes more of them to make a centimeter, so you're going to have less of a centimeter. What relationship can you use to express the number of millimeters in centimeters? Well, 10 millimeters is equal to 1 centimeter, so 1 millimeter is equal to 1/10 of a centimeter, or we could say 0.1. Take 1 divided by 10 on our calculator. Let's turn it on there. 1 divided by 10, that equals 0.1. Okay? How many centimeters are in 26.5 millimeters? Well, 26.5 millimeters times 0.1 centimeters per millimeter is equal to, well, there's two ways we can do it. We can, because we're multiplying by 0.1, probably the best way to do is take our calculator, and we can do 26.5, and we're going to multiply that by 0.1, and we end up with 2.65. Okay? So there's going to be 2.65 centimeters for the diameter of a loonie. Okay? The metric staircase can help you convert a linear measure from one unit to another. When going from a smaller unit to a larger unit, the exponent on the power of 10 you multiply equals the number of steps between the units. Okay? So this is just one way that you can help yourself to memorize or to learn or to figure out which way to move the decimal point in the metric system between units. Okay, so start on the practice.